You know, we don't have any other place to be but here, because we have to figure our way back from all of this.
One of our signs said, from the back of the bus to the front of the prison. Those who don't know had to pause and think until they realized our civil rights struggle is not over. Not for black folks, not for Latinos, not for queer and trans, not for Asian and not for poor white folks. The struggle is never over. And the game has changed. As most have come to realize, the prison industrial complex is the new Jim Crow.
We represent unfinished business in this room. Yes. Whoever got the mic need to tell them that black people are having their votes stolen in massive numbers.
Massive.
We came to Alabama with a purpose: to reignite the civil rights movement under the banner of those fighting this new Jim Crow, and to organize those of us affected by the whip of the criminal justice system. We began by calling ourselves formerly incarcerated and convicted people, understanding that we are unified with our brothers and sisters still on the inside, and committed to developing an organizing structure that can spread throughout the millions in America with a similar condition. We use the phrase 10 million to acknowledge the number of people currently under government control.
We have 195% of prison capacity. The budget within the state is about 20% of our general fund budget. But if it were based upon us keeping up with national prison standards, it would be about 40%.
A dedicated steering committee of 8 formerly incarcerated people concluded the time to act was now. 56 leaders representing 12 states came together in the first strategic session of its kind.
Free them all!
Free them all!
Free the land!
Free the land!
Free the land!
We assessed our place throughout the history of this struggle, the successes, obstacles, and failures. We need to know where we've been and where we're at so we can get to where we're going. We came away with a structure of regional caucuses to empower a national caucus, with the idea that millions of people can and should be able to speak in one voice.
United, we'll never be defeated!
We marched over Edmund Pettus Bridge, back into Selma, to rededicate ourselves to the unfinished business. 2 members of each region will join the National Steering Committee as we further develop the tools to organize. We will form the working committees for media and communications, fundraising, and research. We toured the Civil Rights Museum, and we could not help but be transported back to the gravity of their situation. We recalled the dangerousness, yet the need, for thousands to stand up on behalf of.
That I was always going to be who I was. She defined me by my behavior, not by who I am.
This is not to create another nonprofit. This is to create a movement. The next step is Los Angeles, November 2nd, 2011. This is when we show America that the dream never died and the oppressed will always rise. Will you be there?